everyone, and welcome to my new Dory paint video. As you could see it, of course, from the thumbnail, today we're going to make one of the most requested dolls on my channel. Every time when I'm making, you know, another celebrity, Billie Eilish, Ariana Grande, BTS dolls, every time one of the most popular comments under these videos is always, please, please, please make a Melanie Martinez doll. Here we are, today we're going to make a Melanie Martinez doll. I honestly think her look from the iconic dollhouse video is just made for us, for doll customizers, and this is exactly what we're going to recreate today. So, welcome to our dollhouse Melanie Martinez transformation. I'm going to do it on this Frankenstein doll. I don't know, it's not like she looks very much like Melanie Martinez, but I think she's ideal for this outfit, for this look, for this, you know, style and vibe. So, I'm going to remove this doll's outfit, cut her hair very short, like I always do it, and meanwhile, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you're here for the very first time. I'm transforming dolls here every week Friday, already for 3 years, so welcome to the family, and I'm going to start working. I use, like usually, my hair dryer to make the rubber hat soft and to melt the glue inside of the hat. And just after about 2 minutes of blowing with hot air, I can disconnect the hat from the body, and then with my tweezers I can remove the rest of the hair from the inside of the hat. And after this I can take pure acetone and I remove her original makeup. Now let's prepare her body as well, and first of all I get rid of this pin in her neck, and then I'm going to sand the complete body with nail buffers to remove the glossy top from the surface to make it matte. Of course, our Melanie Martinez just cannot be green, so the next step is covering both the face and the body with a couple of layers of acrylics. And I'm using my airbrush for it. After this, when the paint gets completely dry, I can start drawing the face using my watercolor pencils. And I work like always with Faber-Castell Albrecht Dürer and with Caran d'Ache Super Color Soft. The Caran d'Ache is actually my favorite one at the moment, and I think I will go for their big box of 120 pencils. It costs almost 300 euro, of course, but I have them in my mind and in my heart already for a year, so I think soon we'll test and unbox some new pencils here on my channel. And by the way, maybe we should make some sort of a video comparing different pencil brands to see which ones work better on dolls. It would be really interesting for me personally to make such an experiment, so please let me know if it's interesting for you as well. I think it could be really fun and also very informative as well, so please let me know in the comments if you need a video like this. And to prepare the surface to be able to draw on it, I use, like always, Mr. Super Clear Sealant. So, and what am I actually doing? I took a couple of reference pictures of Melanie from the Dollhouse music video, and now I will try to recreate the makeup very close to the original. A silver pencil to her eyelids, but actually a couple of layers of Mr. Super Clear will make this silver color look completely matte. So I will still add some silver paint on top of it in the very end of my work. You know, I prefer to spray freckles on doll faces using some hard brush because it always gives a very realistic end result, but today I'm going to draw freckles just like this, just as single dots, because this is how it's made on Melanie's face on the reference picture. And after I have finished the face, I still need to blush the body using the same soft pastels. And after this, we will talk about her outfit. I've asked my mom to make an exactly the same dress like we can see in the Dollhouse video. And this is actually how she has made it. Thank you. So this is the finished outfit, and it looks really amazing, I think. And it looks really exactly like the original dress. Look at all these tiny details, it's just adorable, really. Now I still want to customize this pair of shoes to complete the outfit, and then we're going to make a wig for my mini Melanie. To make the iconic two-colored wig, I'm going to use these two types of yarn. Well, with the black yarn it's all plain and simple, and on this pink one I still will have to work some extra later. But first of all, let's turn this yarn first into hair and then into wefts like always. You've seen this transformation already many times, of course, if you watch my videos sometimes, so let's do it again. When the wefts are ready, I take my glue gun and I make a wig for my doll using my regular wig making technique. Now, of course, this pink part is much lighter than Melanie's hair. And she also has a purple gradient closer to the ends of her hair. So I'm going to use these fabric markers from Arteza. I've used them already a couple of times to dye doll hair and it always worked perfectly. So let's use this selection of pink and purple markers to dye her hair and to create the gradient. I let the markers dry for 7 hours and now we're going to make curls using a barbecue stick and a flat iron. So this is how our wig looks in the end. I'm really very happy with the end result. It all looks very pretty and the hair color and the gradient and the curls and the bangs. Really, I'm super happy with the end result. So now I can finally attach the false lashes and add glossy varnish to her eyes and lips. And this time I'm going to add false lower lashes as well because I can see it on the reference picture. And now I can finally add the silver paint to the eyelids. Remember, I've told you about in the beginning of this repaint, so now it's the time. So now I think we can finally put everything together and then we'll take a look at the end result pictures. And here is finally our doll version of Melanie Martinez. I still think that look is just ideal to recreate on a doll. I didn't even have to draw the joints on her elbows because she already has them naturally. And her makeup also looks so dollish. And the dress is just straight from the picture. And the wig is so adorable. Just love, 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 love it. But, you know, it's me and it's my taste. I don't know. And what do you think about our mini Melanie? I'm like always looking forward to read your thoughts and your opinions in the comments. And I would also like to ask you, like always, who else should we recreate in the doll form? The very next one will be another BTS doll from the recent Mattel release. But who should we make after this? Please leave your ideas under this video, sooner or later we will make them all. And this doll is now available for sale on eBay for 3 days, so if you wanted to buy one of my dolls, now is the moment. So this was my doll transformation of the week, guys. I really hope you enjoyed it today. And if so, please don't forget to support my art here on YouTube with your likes. Of course, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell button, and I will see you already very, very, very soon next week, Friday, in my new doll repaint video. Love you guys. Bye.